Hello friends, today I'm going to show you how to model a video player using the Stately Studio Visual Editor. I'm going to start off creating myself a new machine. I'm going to call that machine Video Player. Now this opens me up a default state machine. It's got the name Video Player and it has a first state, a second state, an event that transitions between those two states. Now in our video player, we want to start off in a minified kind of thumbnail mode and go to a full screen mode when the video is playing. So my first state is going to be the mini state. Now that mini state is the initial state of the video player. It's the default state that the video player exists in. Now just so that the rest of my team understand what I mean by mini, I'm going to select the mini state, open up the state details panel, and I'm going to add a description, and I'm just going to call this the minified thumbnail mode. And that way everyone on the team will understand what I mean by mini. Just going to close that panel out. Now the second state in our video player is that full screen state. So I'm going to call that state full. And in order to transition between the mini and full states, I'm going to have a toggle event. I also want to be able to transition back from the full state to the mini state. So selecting the full state, I'm going to drag a transition back to the mini state, and I'm going to call that toggle as well. Often when people are using video players, they want keyboard shortcuts to work as well. And one of the most common ones is the escape keyboard shortcut. You all know it when a video starts playing and you don't want it to play, you just want to hit the escape key. So we're going to create a transition to accommodate that too. So this transition is going to go from full back to mini again, and we are going to name that event key.escape. One of the great things about state charts is that you can actually create child states. You can nest states inside of each other. So we're going to make full state into parent state with children inside of it. I'm going to do that using the state button here, the plus state button. And inside there, we now have a new state. It's an initial state itself, but it's the default state that we enter when we enter the full state. And that is going to be playing. So when we enter the full state, the video is going to be playing. We also want to create another state inside of our full state, and that is going to be stopped. The event that takes us from playing to stopped is going to be the video.ended event. Now, often when you're playing a video, when it's stopped playing, you don't need to keep that video in its full screen mode. You want to go back to minified mode. So we're going to create a transition that starts in the stop state and goes back to the mini state. Now this event, we're actually going to make into a special type of event. If we right click on an event, it brings up this quick actions menu. And we're going to choose a different event type. We're going to choose an event type of after. So what this transition is now doing is saying, when we have been in the stopped state for 500 milliseconds, return to the mini state. Now that's all great. That means that when the user has stopped playing the video, they just have a brief amount of time before return to the mini state. So it doesn't just go really quickly. You don't really know what's happened. Although 500 milliseconds is a really short amount of time. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change that length of time by selecting the event itself. I'm going to go to the transition details and I'm going to change the delay on that event to 2000 milliseconds. Now you can see that this little delayed event, the after event, says 2 seconds. So that's one of the nice little details we've got in the studio. Human readable timers. It makes a lot more sense to have 2 seconds than 2000 milliseconds. Next up, we want to add some effects to our full state. What we want to do is make sure that the video is behaving in the right way when we're in the full screen state. I'm going to select our state details panel and I'm going to scroll down here to the effects section. Now what we want is to make sure that the video is played when we go into full screen mode. So I'm going to create an entry action, an action that is executed on entry to the full state, and I'm going to call that play video. And we also want to have an exit action when we exit out of the full screen state, and that is going to be pause video. That is not going to stop the video so much as just pause it, so that if you return to the video later, you'll be able to start playing again from the same position. Just going to save that. We also want to have some actors that are going to be invoked by the full state. We're going to have one that listens out for video ended. And we also want to add a listener that listens out for that key escape key press that we mentioned earlier. Now, if I close the state details panel, zoom out a touch to give us a good overview of the whole of our video player machine right now, I think that's looking good. Now we're ready to go into code. I'm going to go into the code mode, and I have the option of JSON, JavaScript, or TypeScript. I'm going to choose JavaScript today, copy that code to my clipboard, and I'm going to go to my demo code in Code Sandbox. Now here I've got an empty create machine object, and I'm going to replace that with the create machine object that was generated for me in the Stately Studio. I'm going to paste that in there. Oh, extra semicolon, don't need that. And save. Make our video space a little bigger so we can see what we're doing. And now you can see, following my model, we can press play, click outside of that to toggle back to mini mode. We can press play to go back into full screen mode, hit escape and go back out into the mini mode. And we can press play, let the video finish, and then after those 2 seconds, it goes back to mini mode. Ta-da! So that was modeling a video player using the Stately Studio visual editor.